So women's singles now, and it's Chloe McGee and Hadia Hosni, an Irish-Egyptian meeting in Group I. This is a group that also includes Pi Hongyang of France. First match of the group. And a first meeting for these two players.
And the next matchup for two is the women's singles competition A Group 1 match, a Group I match, apologies. Please welcome, representing Ireland, Chloe McGee.
And a few Irish fans here, I think, tonight. Celebrating and supporting McGee. And Hadia Hosni, well, she might have a few fans here as well because she's actually based in Bath in England. And here is Chloe McGee, the poster girl for Irish badminton when she won a match in Beijing at the Olympics as a teenage girl. She's 4 years on now facing Hadia Hosni here, who celebrates her 24th birthday tomorrow. And the service judge waiting to do the preliminaries here. Matchup, this isn't it? 23-year-old from Donegal against a 23-year-old from Egypt. Chloe McGee, 44th in the world, from Rafo in Donegal, what the McGee family describe as a one-horse town. A great journey, of course, in Beijing. Warmly applauded by the crowds there, and then almost quit the sport. 4 months later, she fell out of love with badminton, returned home to Ireland. She was out in Sweden, but obviously now very much in tune with her game again, coached by her brother and his, Hadia Hosni, who's also doing an MSc in medical biosciences at the University of Bath. She's based in England, coached by an Englishman. Outside the top 100 in the world is Hosni, but at 113 in the world, she is the number one player from Africa. But Chloe McGee, Jill, obviously some high hopes for her in terms of Irish badminton. And she and I suppose Scott Evans, isn't it, in the men's singles, they've been flying the flag as far as Ireland are concerned. Put it, badminton on the map.
Yes, indeed. And you know, I think she's shown some good form of late. She reached the final of the White Knights tournament in Russia, and you know, she's a real, real fighter on court. She's a very physical player. You can see she's a very strong athlete, and will run and run all day. She certainly won't give up fighting. It's interesting, though, the point you were making about the fact that she fell out of love with badminton. I think for so many players and athletes probably in general that qualify for the Olympic Games, it's such an occasion. And because of our Olympic qualifying system, it's not necessarily all the players that are regularly on the elite level tournaments. There's some players, as you say, from Africa, from lesser badminton nations.
There's your mark. There's a time, isn't it? She's employing McGee here. Egyptian wins the first point. First Egyptian, first Arabic badminton player to compete in the Olympic Games. A lot of pain at the moment. There's a couple of other matches that are on court at the same time. There's our tensions here on this Irish-Egyptian encounter. You recall two traditional badminton countries, and it should make for a fascinating watch. McGee here will be favourite, do you know?
Yes, I think so. Good form of late, rekindled her spirit of loving the game. I think after Beijing there was a real anti-climax.
Got an angle though from Hosni, yeah, fabulous shot.
Yes, and it's interesting because her coach, Peter Bush, former England international player, he was a tall left-hander and he was renowned for the angled shots that he's used to use the whole time, and it's already, I can see a bit of his style of play coming out in Hosni.
Yeah, I saw her in training at Wembley a couple of days ago. Basically training against men. Yeah, I think she's up against one of the African players, Air King, is it?
That's right. Yeah.
Well, Badminton was a little bit of an unknown quantity in Egypt before she arrived and changed it with her progress. 35 Egyptian women actually in London 2012, the most it's ever fielded, the largest female delegation from any of the Arabic or Islamic countries. Sciences. Obviously, I wouldn't know where to start on that, but also trying to play 21 tournaments worldwide at the same time. Doing this, you know, essays and the likes on aeroplanes and trying to qualify for the Olympics.
Yes, very difficult, but I have to say, the University of Bath, where she is studying, their sports facilities and their setup is really absolutely fantastic for a lot of sports people. Over a whole variety of sports, it really is a wonderful setup, wonderful university too. And in fact, that is where the Malaysian team, badminton team, were based prior to the start of these Olympic Games. They had a little training camp there, such is the quality of their training facilities.
She's trying to be as aggressive as she can here in the opening exchanges. For Blair, and finding it so early on with such regularity as she is. As the opponent, we're hoping it's just go to the wrong side of the line, but that's not been the case. At home, she was out in Scandinavia in and around the time of Beijing. Has played for a club team in Germany, but she has it now for her matches. Gee's perspective, I suppose the draw is as good as she could have hoped for, you know. Up against Hosni here and Pyongyang, the highest seeded player in the group to come. She's a much mature, better athlete than she was 4 years ago. She lost quite a lot of weight, 5 kilograms lighter.
Oh, that's nice. Came from above the shuttle as she came to the net. So often players approach the net with the racket held low, but she came with the racket held high, and then of course you've got so many more options.
For Chloe McGee, 11 points to 8. Finding a stride in the last 3 points. And brother Dan.
Yeah, I think she's just settled now, Richard. 4 straight points to go to the mid-game interval.
Yeah, their dad ran the local badminton club. They're all at it. I think they've got a younger brother as well. He's coming up through the ranks now too. Dan used to play as well. And coaching that. Good relationship having with your brother if you're going to have him bossing you around the whole time.
Yeah, but it's also, I mean, you probably trust your family more than anyone else, so it has its advantages and disadvantages, I'm sure. Found the back corner quite beautifully. It's a good rally.
Yeah, a very even match so far. Well, this one's got the potential to go to the wire. Thank you.
just long.
She's got this 3-point advantage here, McGee. Just needs to try and keep Osney at arm's length.
Going wide, I don't think she knew we have played it.
I think the way she looked back at where the shuttle came from, she realizes that as well.
Pushing and probing. Okay, Hosni twist and turn.
Just dropped it. And she's maintained this 3-point lead consistently from the interval. 11-8 then, 16-13 now. That is right on the line.
Second time she's found that deep backhand corner, isn't it?
Jill as well, and she said it was one of the best moments of her life.
Yes, and I always think it's a terrible shame that so many athletes do miss the opening ceremony, but of course they are here to compete, and if you're competing the very next day, then it doesn't make a lot of sense to go to the opening ceremony. But
which didn't finish till, you know, midnight, gone
yeah.
Midnight. Up a little now, hasn't it, in this opening game. Just 1 point between them.
She's got very good court coverage, hasn't she, Chloe McGee?
Big cry of come on after that point. Trying to G herself up to try and close out this opening game.
Yeah.
So game points have arrived here for Chloe McGee. 3 game points. And a chance here for the Irish girl to get herself halfway towards the winning mark. In that opening game. She had a great win here last year at the World Championships, beat Adrianti Fedasari of Indonesia, one of the terrific young players from that country. I think that was the biggest of her career, but if she can beat Hosni here, well, she could take the scalp of Pihong, and I think that might top it. But of course, this match far from done and dusted. It was pretty tight in that opening game, Drew, 21-17. But she looked the better player all round, doesn't she? Although Hosni has played some lovely shots and found the corners and the lines a fair few times.
Yeah, I think Chloe McGee is physically quicker on the court and perhaps a little stronger.
Don't move too early. Yeah? Second thing, think about. Smashes, her smashes are quite flat, so you're looking, so defensively you're looking down too deep, look is a little bit higher, so you can try and counter from that, the safe defence, those two things, yes, good effort first set, excellent set, alright, I'm proud of you girl, yes,
that's okay. Lovely, isn't it?
Well, yeah. Alright, it really is good.
Well, شكرا جاي والله سهلة هذه ممكن تحديه والله ربنا يصل إن شاء الله.
Take your time between the points. Excellent first set. Now we get stuck in. Do you feel okay? Yeah? I'm really impressed. Really impressed.
Yeah, good to hear Pete Bush encouraging his player, praising her. It is remarkable, isn't it? Now. Similar she is in style in so many ways to the way he used to play. I find it very, very intriguing the way, you know, he passes on some of his philosophy, he passes on some of his skills to
How
his
good
players.
A player was Pete Bush then?
Certainly international. Yeah. I'm trying to think whether he was in the final of the national championships or maybe a semi-final, I can't really remember. But
yeah, he was an England international.
Very much so, very much so. Very good player.
That's a good start in the second game, though. Encouraging words from Pete Bush, bringing the ears of Hania Hosni. Needs to get a foothold in this game. That's clever, that's well played. Lovely little touch, wasn't it?
Great score. Oh, that's clever too. It was a wonderful defensive shot, first of all from Hosni and then from McGee. Look at that, that's delightful.
Yeah, she's raised the game a little, hasn't she, here at the start of the second. And McGee has herself a pretty good lead. 1 game and now 5 love. Hosni off the mark.
Yeah, I was saying earlier, Richard, about McGee and her. She looks a stronger athlete on court, stronger mover. And this is the sort of thing that I think Cosny, her opponent, has got to be working on, because there she didn't spring forward to the net. Same again there. She has problems with that real explosive power, moving herself towards the shuttle. She's got delightful skills.
And we haven't heard, we didn't hear Dan, her brother, talking, but it looks like they've spotted that during this match, or they spotted it beforehand. She's played a lot of similar shots at the start of the second that have proved to be fruitful for her.
Yeah, that's a lovely winner from Hosni. But you're absolutely right. I think on the defensive shots, Chloe McGee, three or four, she's turned the shuttle already in this second game. The cross on the defensive shot.
But there we go again.
Yeah, absolutely. She's really looking to sort of encroach in early on the net and try and take the shuttle as early as possible. Wonderful spinning net shot. And as you say, once again, Hosni really struggling with that explosive change of movement, change of direction.
So 11-3, the interval lead for Chloe McGee. Not for Harvey Hosni here. Difficult for coach, is it? Because he doesn't want to pick holes in a game and make her feel down about it, but he's also got to try and tell her what to watch out for. It's a fine balance, isn't it?
It is, and I think he did it very well. So I think you're playing good, I think you're playing well, but she's just playing a little bit quicker than you at the moment, so you've got to put all your energy into this to try and take the shuttle early at the net and just give it everything you've got. There we go.
What a busy bee at the other end, isn't she, Chloe McGee? And she says she feels in really good shape. She's feeling her form is good. And we're seeing that here, Chloe McGee. And should she go on and win from here? And obviously it looks like at the moment she will. It's going to be an interesting match you'll have against Pihanyan.
Oh, lovely rally. Oh, what a difference when she does address the shuttle. Great control low down from Hosni, but... And just picking up on your point, Richard, I think it's a very, very interesting matchup. Perhaps if McGee does win this one, and it, you know, in all honesty, it looks likely at the moment, but... Pihanyan has had injury problems after injury problems, and in fact had a minor knee operation. Having qualified for the Olympics, was in so much pain she decided to quickly have a keyhole surgery on her knee. So she's literally coming back from surgery, and if
I mean, you've got a player like McGee at the other end of
the court that will run and run and run, it is going to be very interesting. Oh, just missed it. That's a pity.
Yeah.
Right idea.
It's a big lead now, though, isn't it?
Judgment. Yeah, thought about hitting it. Not wide by a whisker. Twisting and turning and the changing of direction that Hosni is struggling, and Chloe McGee is really exploiting that.
It's out, and it's getting closer now to what's turning into a comprehensive win here for Chloe McGee. First set was pretty tight, and now at 19-6. That's very different second game, isn't it? And we have match points already. She has been very effective in the second game, Chloe McGee. Ruthless. Brilliant performance from Chloe McGee. She wins another match and an Olympic Games. She won one in Beijing, and now she's got one at London 2012. 21-17, 21-6, her victory over Hadia Hosni of Egypt. She just got better as the match went on, didn't she?
Yes, her physicality certainly helped, but tactically as well, I think she played that second game so well.
So confirmation of the scoreline then, Chloe McGee in this Group I women's singles match. She's seen off Harry Hosni, still has Pi Hongyan of France to play. Chinese-born French player. And nothing really much to tell you from those stats. Hosni played pretty well in that first game, but was outgunned in the second.